worship is from Psalm 10. Arise, Lord, lift up your hand, O God, do not forget the helpless. You, O God, do see trouble and grief. You consider it to take it in hand. The victim commits himself to you. You are the helper of the fatherless. Chapter 8, verses 1 through 13. Now about food sacrificed to idols, we know that we all possess knowledge. Knowledge puffs up, but love builds up. The man who thinks he knows something does not yet know as he ought to know, but the man who loves God is known by God. So then, about eating food sacrificed to idols, we know that an idol is nothing at all in the world, and that there is no God but one. For even if there are so-called gods, whether in heaven or on earth, as indeed there are many gods and many lords, yet for us there is but one God, the Father, from whom all things came and for whom we live. And there is but one Lord, Jesus Christ, through whom all things came and through whom we live. But not everyone knows this. Some people are still so accustomed to idols that when they eat such food, they think of it as having been sacrificed to an idol. And since their conscience is weak, it is defiled. But food does not bring us near to God. We are no worse if we do not eat, and no better if we do. Be careful, however, that the exercise of your freedom does not become a stumbling block to the weak. For if anyone with a weak conscience sees you who have this knowledge eating in an idol's temple, won't he be emboldened to eat what has been sacrificed to idols? So this weak brother for whom Christ died is destroyed by your knowledge. When you sin against your brothers in this way and wound their weak conscience, you sin against Christ. Therefore, if what I eat causes my brother to fall into sin, I will never eat meat again, so that I will not cause him to fall.
My, my. Say, that's pretty swell. Gee, thanks. But, don't it get a badge or something?
Well, we'll see.
You mean maybe it will?
I shouldn't wonder.
Make it a gold one?
Maybe. Now remember, Pinocchio, be a good boy. And always let your conscience be your guide. Goodbye, my lady.
Not bad, says I. Oh, yeah. Almost forgot about you. Well, Pinocchio, maybe you and I had better have a little heart-to-heart talk.
Why?
Well, you want to be a real boy, don't you?
Uh-huh.
All right. Sit down, son. Now, you see, the world is full of temptations.
Temptations?
Yep, temptations. They're the wrong things that seem right at the time. But even though the right things may seem wrong sometimes, sometimes the wrong things may be right at the wrong time, or vice versa. Understand?
But I'm going to do right.
Attaboy, Pinocchio, and I'm going to help you. And anytime you need me, you know, just whistle. Like this.
Like this?
No, try it again, Pinocchio.
Like this?
No, son. Now listen. That's it. Come on now. Let's sing it. When you get in trouble and you don't know right from wrong, give a little whistle. Give a little whistle. When you meet temptation and the urge is very strong, give a little whistle. Give a little whistle. Not just a little squeak. Pucker up and blow. And if your whistle's weak, yell.
Jiminy Cricket.
Right. Take the straight and narrow path. And if you start to slide, give a little whistle. Give a little whistle. And always let your conscience be your guide.
What is the most important attribute of a follower of Jesus Christ and a church, a Christian church? What is the most important characteristic? Is it knowledge? Knowing the exact doctrine and knowing everything? Everything possible? Is it our freedom? Freedom to do anything we want to? Well, certainly the world suggests that knowledge and freedom, our American culture suggests, knowledge and freedom are the two most important things we possess. Knowledge and freedom as a basis for our actions with others, our activities, our relationships with others, is really summed up in the popular cultural icon, Jiminy Cricket, when he says, "Let your conscience be your guide." Knowledge and freedom, are they really the most important part of a Christian's life and the life of a church? I say no, and so does Paul in this rather interesting scripture reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 8. Paul says that love, the love of God that we experience through Jesus Christ and that we have for God and for others, is the most important characteristic, attribute of a Christian's life, of a Christian church. We are free, but we do not flaunt our freedom. We constrain our freedom in love for others. The most important attribute, the most fundamental characteristic of a Christian life and a Christian congregation is love, not knowledge, not freedom. The greatest experience for a person who enters the Christian community is love, not freedom, not knowledge. Love flows into our lives as we open ourselves to God through faith in Jesus Christ. As Augustine writes, love God and do what you will. As you love God, your will is united with God. Your life overflows with God's love. Will it be Jiminy Cricket for you or Jesus Christ? Jiminy Cricket says, let your conscience be your guide. He depends on knowledge and freedom. Do we value superior knowledge and personal freedom over all things? Jesus Christ says to let the love of God be your guide. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and soul and mind. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. Now, you and I probably, as followers of Jesus Christ, won't do everything right. I know I don't. But we'll try and we'll miss now and then. Let us, though, never forget to love in the Spirit of Christ, loving God and loving others as ourselves. It is, after all, love that builds up our lives and our families and our church.
We are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord, we are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord, and we pray that our unity may one day be restored, and they'll know. They'll know we are Christians by our love. We will walk with each other, we will walk hand in hand, we will walk with each other, we will walk hand in hand, and together we'll spread the news that God is in our land, and they'll know we are Christians by our love, yes, they'll know we are Christians by our love. We will work with each other, we will work side by side. Things come, and all praise to